Think I need a handy assistant. Can you hand me the glue in the cupboard behind me?
Okay.
Whoa! Careful. Sorry, I forgot. That thing isn't too stable. Let me just...
Okay. Sorry.
My fault. Your grandmother keeps telling me, but I'm a lazy old man. Hey, can you close the door? I want to talk for a second.
Oh.
Okay.
It's the power cable, of course. Yeah, it happens all the time. So, listen, I've noticed things with Daniel.
Okay.
You know what I'm talking about, don't you?
Play it cool. Oh, tell the truth. Ooh. I think he's talking about something else, not the powers. So I'm gonna hide the secret.
Not really. What things?
Well, I'm not sure how to put it. Like, some kind of invisible force, the holy gift or something.
Yeah. Daniel likes to pretend he's got superpowers, but that's it.
That's it?
Mm.
Okay. But be careful, Sean. You know, he's still so young.
Sure.
And by the way, let's keep this between us.
Okay.
Claire has a lot of strong beliefs. She wouldn't understand. She adores Daniel.
Mm.
And just wants both of you to be safe and happy.
Happy.
What I'm trying to say is maybe you should stay here with us. I know you boys plan to run to Mexico, but...
We have a home in Puerto Lobos.
Yeah.
Dad wanted to return there. Two Mexican boys out on the run? That won't be a secret in Beaver Creek for long.
No, America is your home. With us. And you have to think about your brother, you know, his future, all that stuff.
It's too dangerous for us to stay here. And for you guys, too.
Yeah.
It's dangerous to be on the road. Do you think your father would have wanted this for his kids?
It's different now.
Of course not. But everything's different now.
I know. I know. Well, just think about it.
Okay.
But don't torture yourself.
I will. Hey, Claire said you had the keys for the tool shed?
Oh, sure. Here. You guys enjoy the sun.
Thanks. Maybe I should have told the truth. I wanted to.
And be careful with that shed. It's probably a mess inside.
Thanks.
Anything else?
It's good to see you in my lair. Even though you were afraid to come in here as a kid.
Really? Why?
No idea. But you're a big boy now. You can take a look around. I won't eat you.
Cool.
I'm sorry, Sean. I know you guys miss your games and your websites. But trust me, a break from all this can only do you good. You know, and it's safer that way.
Yeah. I know. Steven sure takes his hobby.
Hmm.
You found this. I just forgot to,
It's okay. It's been a while since I've...
Yeah.
...seen her face.
Yeah. I like taking a look at it from time to time.
Doesn't it hurt?
Yeah.
Yeah, it does. But she's still my daughter, you know? I can't approve what she's done, but I think I understand.
Good.
Yeah.
I don't.
I'm sorry, Jean. Please don't...
Tell her about that.
Please don't say anything to Claire about this, okay?
Don't worry. I won't.
He keeps a secret picture of her in a place where his wife will never find it.
How come you have a disco ball? Are you, like, throwing parties and stuff?
Sorry. The video cut out, I'm sorry. I can't shake the feeling that we're not safe here, that something's gonna happen. Daniel's gonna reveal his powers. Claire's gonna freak and we're gonna have to run.
Grandma during a disco night. Believe it or not.
Claire told me you guys have been married for like 40 years, so it kind of makes sense.
That sure was a long time ago, but we stuck together, you know, through thick and thin.
That's cool.
Well, call me old-fashioned, but I think that's how marriage should be.
Man, who did this?
Oh, it was our neighbor's son, Chris. Yeah, I helped him and his dad build that treehouse.
Why are you holding a fire sword?
I'm not sure. You know, that kid sure has an imagination.
Oh, there you are, Sean. Got the key? Hey, I have to go out and run some errands. Can you do me a big favor? Do you know how to work a washing machine?
Since I was about 8.
Of course. Can you throw in yours and your brother's clothes after the next load? They're in the bathroom basket.
Totally, yeah. No problem.
Thanks so much. Feel free to keep on tidying your stuff, too. It's good for the health to keep the house clean.
Definitely. Daniel can help.
Ah, and remember, for your own safety, no phone and no internet.
Yeah.
I know, boring rules.
Don't worry, Claire. Hey, Daniel! There's work for you!
No! I'm busy!
Busy my ass! Come over here!
You gotta find me first!
Jeez. Oh!
Thought he went in the cupboard.
I get that he's sick of all this shit, but why are we playing this game? I know you're in there. Gotcha! What the?
Behind you!
Yeah, very funny. No more hiding. Seriously.
Okay. What do I have to do?
You tidy the mess in our room, and I take care of the laundry. Cool?
Again? We always have to clean everything. I don't wanna.
Yeah, I hear you. Never mind, okay?
Cool. Okay. Thanks, Sean.
Pick up the laundry basket.
All right. Let's get it over with.
I like this house. It's small, but homely. It's snug.
All right. Time to take care of that laundry.
Yeah.
Thanks, Claire. How many programs does this thing have? Okay. It will do.
Wonder if the fact that I didn't take the previous loadout is going to be wrong.
Pretty different from the one we had back at home. What the hell are you doing?
I just picked up the phone.
You know what, dude? We're not supposed to be here. Who was it?
I don't know. Some kid? It was just a prank, Sean.
I know. Just be careful, okay?
Don't worry.
That's the phone call that I made earlier.
Hey, what's up? Oh, excuse me, sir. You did not win a ticket for this train. You got a handshake.
Come on, Chief. I just want to see how this works.
Now, I could be a real superhero and save the train from disaster.
I remember playing this when I came here years ago. Man, things were so different back then.
I can move it a bit more.
This model is so amazing.
Yeah! Grandpa says it took decades to build. Can you believe it?
It's crazy.
It's way cooler than anything I ever did in Minecraft.
Daniel looks like a total thug in his new pajamas.
Done that one. Just want to clean the room.
That's a cool memento.
Yep, done that.
Secret cabin in the woods.
Alright, we don't have to clean the room then.
Hey man, can you fix this frame up there?
Easy.
Don't overdo it.
Let's see.
It's so weird to be back here again. Claire and Steven are kind of weird sometimes, but they do care about us. I'm glad they're spoiling Daniel.
Fish.
Wish I could. Dad never really got along with them, though. I barely know them.
I think it was the family, right? Maybe.
We're safe. That's all I need.
For now. Can you fix the ship in the bottom?
Sean!
Oh, shit!
Got you!
Seriously, man!
Chicken.
Can you fix it?
Hey, do you think you can fix that?
Gee, that's pretty small. Let me try.
Don't smash it.
I did it! Hey, check out the sail! So this was Mom's ship?
I don't know, man. I guess.
I got a ship in the bottle. It's not as fancy as that, but it's still pretty nice to have. I like the fact that it's there.
Daniel, you ready? We can go out now.
Yes! Wait for me!
I like that the snow does actually leave proper tracks that you can actually see.
Man, finally!
Where you went.
It feels so good to be outside. Reminds me of the cabin. Right? Oh! Ow!
Oh! Oh, oh, oh!
Watch out for the pack.
Hello, bird.
Get ready for storage wars.
What's wrong?
Frozen shut. Of course.
All right, here we go.
Sean, look!
And you break that, yeah. There we go.
Did you see that?
See what? We just got here. Are you okay?
Yeah. I didn't see anything either.
Okay, I just fell down into the snow. Dad says I'm kind of clumsy.
That's an awesome costume. Who's your favorite superhero? I love Power Bear!
Yeah. Oh man! I have the Mega Power Bear! You should check it out!
Dude, that's so cool!
Chris, oh god. Look, I am so sorry. Are you okay?
Dad, I'm fine. I promise.
Are you sure? Listen, I shouldn't... Do you know them?
It's okay, Dad. They're cool. He loves superheroes, even Power Bear.
Ah, gotcha. Hey there. Are you staying with the Reynolds? Yeah. But not for long. We're just passing by. I see. Oh, geez, Chris. You don't have any damn shoes on. I'm sorry, buddy. Let's get you inside.
Yeah. Okay, Dad.
Thanks, guys. Oh, and, if Claire asks, tell her everything is fine.
Sure. No problem.
Cool. See you around, then.
See you around. Okay.
Thanks, guys. See you later.
Yes, we will.
Daniel, did you forget everything about the rules already?
Sorry, Sean. Did you want me to let him fall?
No.
Really?
No, you... You did the right thing. But listen, we can't let anybody know. We have to keep a low profile out here.
He's like my age. I bet you would have done the same exact thing. Don't be mad.
I'm not mad, dude. It's...
It's more that
it's over. Daniel.
Careful.
Remember that we're hiding out. So no training and no showing off your power. From now on, you stick with me all the time, okay?
Okay. Whew. And that was the little instance that I got to before the demo ended on the other game. That's how it ties in, really, but that's not... I didn't really need to see that all that. It wasn't really necessary, I don't think.
Fuck. That kitten never listens.
Nearly stepped on my phone. Just going for a drink. There we go.
Okay. Time to get Daniel at the Erickson's.
Yeah. What do you think? He's gonna do something where he gets very angry with the dad gets
Claire?
Angry.
Steven!
Has to power move it out of there.
Anybody home?
Well... looks like I'm home alone. Oh, right. Sunday morning. Claire and Steven must be at church.
Church, yeah.
Dude, move your ass. Who knows what Daniel's doing over there?
About the computer.
Jeez. Steven went search crazy on us. Look at this.
Press conference. Considering leads. Answered. Loss of mechanic. Oh, so that's good.
These articles are almost a month old. Maybe they stopped looking for us? What the hell is this? I had no idea Steven could fall for this bullshit conspiracy theories.
How did the police die? Where did the explosion come from? How did the fugitive brothers get around? Why are the police being so secretive? No way it was a natural explosion. Blew up his toilet. No. Okay, that's it. Can't, yes, visit Brody's blog.
Well, Brody.
A tribe called West.
If we ever make it home, wherever that is, you'll be much, much welcome.
Yes. Read that awful account here. I might be able to do that. First, best thoughts. kind of nice. So the last article was just about the nudist, which is a lot less creepy when you read it and you understand what's actually going on. It's kind of cool. Yeah, I don't think we're going to be staying here much longer. They're at church.
Well, I guess they won't be back for at least 2 hours.
So let's go next door and sort this out. I think the dad's gonna come home. There's gonna be some stuff that happens, and we'll have to leave in a hurry.
Okay.
Again.
Let's get this Brack back home now. Why does Daniel never listen? Maybe I'm doing it wrong. Wow. That's a lot of beer.
That is a lot of beer.
Daniel, what's going on here?
Sean, wait. Don't freak out. I can't explain.
Let me tell him. Sean, I know it sounds crazy, but I have a superpower. You saw me yesterday. I know you did. I was flying. I can move things. Objects. With my mind.
Oh. A superpower. Really?
Yes.
Great. And you don't realize what that implies? Everyone can see you from the outside. You could get in real trouble. This is dangerous. Do you understand?
Yes. We hear you. We promise to be careful.
This is just our secret, okay? Nobody can find out I'm the real Captain Spirit.
And nobody will.
No.
Ever.
Now you're an official member of the Spirit Squad. If you betray us, I'll disintegrate you. Nah, just kidding. Oh yeah, we need a... team signal.
Totally! No. I'm gonna be... Super Wolf. What's your super name, Sean?
How about the Silver Runner? Cool? Cool, right?
For like the
Not
wolf.
Bad. That's true, you're a great runner.
Okay, guys, I think we're ready to roll. Excuse me. Who are you?
I'm Sean.
Oh yeah, sorry man. You're here for Daniel. Hey, let's make it official. I'm Charles Erickson.
Nice to meet you.
Hope you know that Daniel and Chris are a dangerous team. We better watch out, or they're gonna take over the world.
Yeah. They share a lot of things. As thick as thieves.
Can we go get the Christmas tree now? We're both ready to fly.
Yes, yes, yes. The team has been waiting too long. Hey, you should come along too. There's nothing going on over here.
Yes! Can't wait to see all the decorations! And Sean, we could buy Christmas presents for Grandma and Grandpa.
Sure.
Okay, sure. I'll go with you guys.
Really?
Yeah,
I just wish Chris and Daniel were excited about going. Okay, team, give me a time out to clean up the back seat. I'll honk when I'm done.
Ooh, can I use the bathroom?
Of course. Oh, you'll see my comic books. I'm glad you're coming too. Hey, you want to see my toys?
Oh, score! The new hot dog man?
Since you're a new member of the team, you have to know everybody. These are Captain Spear's friends and his enemies.
Dude, that's pretty cool.
Can you guess who are the good guys and the villains?
Let's see.
Villains. heroes.
Look closely.
Villain.
You sure?
Hero. Villain. Hero.
Care.
Okay. How did I do?
Not bad. You're almost right. It was a bit tricky. Okay. Let me introduce them to you. This is Team Spirit. The good guys.
The T-Rex is the good guy.
There's Forest Warrior, Power Bear, more T-Rex, and Sky Pirate.
So, who are the bad guys?
That's Noctarius and the Shark Stinger. There's also Snowmancer, but he's out in the garden. But they're all working for Mantroid, who's the real supervillain.
So, where is he?
Hiding out on his evil planet, waiting for me. But Captain Spirit and Super Wolf will make sure he doesn't hurt anyone.
Yeah, strength in numbers. Sounds like Mantroid is in trouble.
Just wait until he sees what Captain Spirit can do now.
Yeah, about that. Does your dad know about any of this? Did he see something yesterday?
No, he didn't see anything, and the power didn't work yesterday. After I fell. Must have been too tired.
Okay, good. I mean, he could be pretty disturbed if he knew.
I'm definitely not telling Dad. I don't wanna freak him out. He's worried about other stuff anyway.
Yeah.
Chris, it's none of my business, but are you and your dad okay?
What do you mean?
I don't know. Claire seems to be worried about you guys. Yesterday, Steven and her talked about your dad. I think they had a talk with him.
Claire's always worried. We're cool. Totally. He's just... he has a hard time being on his own.
Okay.
That's all.
Well, I can understand that. But I hope you know you're not alone.
Thanks, Sean. But I don't feel scared anymore. I have the power, and I have Daniel.
There's the signal. Come on, Daniel.
Hey! Pro tip, don't go in there.
Okay, squad. Let's roll. You need my jacket? I don't want you catching another cold.
No, I'm good. Thanks.
And don't be waving your arms around when I'm driving, okay?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Jeez.
Thanks for clearing the snow from the porch. You're awesome.
You're welcome, Dad.
Okay. I don't know. I guess I'm tired. I don't have much to say again. I'm sorry. I'm gonna call it a night, I think. Might have to go back for some of that. I think it's, you know, it was inevitable that the son would find out about the powers, but the fact that Daniel has passed it off and made him think that it's his power kind of makes me worried now that what he'll do in the future and how he'll be. Like, he'll try and do something with his new power that he would get him into trouble or get him hurt, because he'll think he can get himself out of it with his power. I think ultimately something's gonna happen. And I am tired. And I think Daniel's gonna have to come to the rescue, or even Sean will have to come to the rescue. The dad will get upset, something will happen, power will be used, and they'll have to run again. Which is a shame, because they could be safe at the grandparents' house, but not forever. I think they'd have to move on eventually. I don't think they could stay there indefinitely. I think that eventually the law would catch up with them there. Also, I think that I should have been truthful with the grandparents about his powers. By lying to him, I made him almost like doubt his own sanity. At his age, that's a bad thing, so I feel sorry about that. Quite there on chapter 2 yet. I promised I wouldn't lie to him again. That's kind of the biggest one there. Honestly, I don't know what the big choice is going to be at the end, and I don't know if there's going to be 3 choices or just 2. It might be that I have to sacrifice myself to save Daniel, or sacrifice Daniel to save myself, something tied to his powers. He's getting stronger and more show-offy about his powers as well, and I think that's very dangerous for him. It's very, very dangerous that if he's shown off with his powers, that he'll get caught or seen or something will happen. Honestly, I think rules are going to be broken. The name of this chapter is Rules, and I think by breaking every single rule, which is what he's been doing, he'll have to learn some very hard lessons for himself. And sometimes you can't protect other people from learning those lessons, just for the basic fact that sometimes when you fall, you have to pick yourself up. You have to learn some things on your own. And no one can really protect you from that. Sometimes in life you have to learn lessons the hard way. And nothing can always be easy. You don't always have someone to shield you, and you don't always want someone to shield you. You want to pick yourself up again. You want to have the perseverance to move on. Makes me think of my own life, which I think is really the purpose of games like this. There's a lot of moral choices and a lot of morals to be seen in here. Unlike Max's power, this one's not tied to time. You can't go back, so I don't think... I think either I'll have to shield Daniel from the truth at the end, or I'll have to let him accept it. I don't know. There's a long road ahead and a lot to do between then and the final choice, and I don't even know what the final choice is. As I said before, I'm keeping away from the videos because I don't want that. As soon as you type in, oh, what happened in episode 1, what choices did the other people make in episode 1, the search engine will automatically go, hey, you want to see what happens in episode 2, 3, 4, 5? And I don't want to see that. I don't want to see any of that because I want my choices to be my own. I don't want to be influenced by someone else until I get to the end, and once I've done the end, then I will go back and look at what other people did on their playthrough. Because ultimately, I want to see how the story turns out for me before it turns out for someone else. So, on that note, I'm going to leave you there because it's late and I'm tired. And I'm not 100% sure that the choices I'm making are correct. So, before I make a blunder, let's wrap it up. I'm just going to do this more often, speaking at the end, I think. I like the music. It's a nice time to talk to you guys, so I'll see you in the next part, and I hope you're enjoying the series so far.